In this video, we're going to go into a little bit more depth on the major products of ortho-para-directed reactions. So, in general, whenever we have an EAS reaction on an ortho-para-director, we're just going to say that the product is a mixture of both the ortho and the para positions. So, if you want to play it safe, you can always just say that it's a mixture, okay? And that's the way that, you know, most textbooks teach it, okay? However, there are a few patterns that might be helpful for us to learn, especially later on when we start talking about specific groups called blocking groups. So let me tell you about the difference between the ortho position and the para position. Well, basically these positions are in competition with each other because they both have advantages. Look, let's say they have an electron donating group, okay? That means it's pushing electrons into the ring and it's an ortho para director, right? Well, the ortho position has an advantage, a clear advantage right from the beginning, because notice that it has two positions instead of one. The para position, there's only one para, but there's two ortho positions. So you might think, well, we're gonna get more ortho product because you have twice as many positions that could react, okay? So that's one way to think about it. There's two times as many positions. But on the other hand, the para position also has an advantage, which is that the para position is usually the one that's less hindered because it's furthest away from the donating group. So it's actually easier to add to that para position even though there's less of them, okay? And in general, when you kind of pair these two together, when you compete them against each other, number versus steric hindrance is usually gonna win. So usually there's gonna be a slight advantage for the para position over the ortho positions, okay? So if in a question you're asked to supply one major product instead of a mixture, if it says specifically which one's the major product, here we can see a sulfonation on toluene, okay? So you can see we've got our SO3, we've got our fuming H2SO4, and look what we're gonna get. What we are gonna get is a major product of para, okay? So you would say that your parasulfonic acid is going to be the major product and your ortho is gonna be the minor, okay? Even though there's more ortho positions, the steric hindrance, the benefit of sterics, is going to make the para the major product, okay? And basically, that's gonna be the rule that we always follow. We're gonna say that para wins out over ortho, okay? If asked to supply one major product. Now, there is one noted exception. And that one exception is if the final product can hydrogen bond with itself, okay? So if the final product can hydrogen bond because of the orientation of the groups, then we would say that the ortho will slightly win. So here you guys can see the nitration of phenol. Notice that here I have my nitric acid, I have my sulfuric acid. We know that we're gonna generate, what is it? It's gonna be the nitronium cation, right? Or my nitronium ion. And we know that OH is an ortho para director, right? Because it has a lone pair. So that means that it's an electron donating. I mean, it has two lone pairs. I'm just saying it has at least one lone pair, right? So we know that it's gonna direct, you know, either next to it, which is ortho, or at the bottom, which is para, okay? But it turns out that in this case, ortho is slightly better. Why? Because if you make it ortho, then you can get a hydrogen bond between the phenol and the nitro group. If you make it para, it's less hindered, so it's easier to add in that way, but it can't interact with itself, so it's not gonna be quite as favored. Now, this ratio actually isn't as big of a difference as you might think. It's actually only gonna be a 60% to 35% ratio. So, meaning that it's not even winning by that much, but still, this would be the only exception where we would expect more ortho, okay? But for everything else, if asked to supply one major product, I mean, you can always say it's a mixture, but if you're asked to supply one, you're usually gonna go with the para product because it's the one that's less sterically hindered. All right, guys, so believe me, you don't need to know these percentages. I'm just giving them as a teaching moment so that you guys can see actual examples in real life and you guys can understand how it plays out, okay? But in general, you can just go with the rules that I'm telling you. All right, guys, so let's move on to the next video.